Yeah, good morning everyone. This is Kanna Babu. This is part 20 of JavaScript. In the last class we discussed about loops and the purpose of loops and everything. Loops are basically divided into two types: range based loop and condition based loop. For loop comes under range based loop, while loop comes under condition based loop. If you know the range, go for loop. If you don't know the range, go for while loop. Before watching this video, watch part 19. You will get clarity on loops. So today we'll see some examples with loops. For example, I want to write a program to print the sum of the numbers. Okay, now sum of the numbers between 1 to 10. Sum of 10 natural numbers. You can tell. Sum of 10 natural numbers. If you want to find the sum of 10 natural numbers, let us see how to write the program. So first of all, open HTML tag. And here close HTML tag, and here you can open head tag, and here you can close head tag. Okay, now and here you can open body tag and close the body tag. Always JavaScript code write inside the head tag. So here within this I'll try to write one script tag. Script type is equal to text slash JavaScript. Is it clear? So how many numbers I want to print? Sum. I want to find the sum of 10 numbers. Okay, na. So here 10 numbers means, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So how to find the sum? Initially, take one variable called sum, where sum is equal to initially 0. And the logic is sum is equal to sum plus I. Here rotate the loop how many times? 10 times. Because how many numbers? 10 numbers. So initial value I is equal to how much? 1. Is it clear? So initially sum is 0. 0 plus 1, 1. 1 plus 2, 3. So after finding the sum, store that result in the same sum variable. Left hand side of the assignment operator is variable. Right hand side of assignment operator is value. So rotate the loop how many times? 10 times. Initial value is 1. Number is incrementing or decrementing? Incrementing. If the number is incrementing, condition is less than or equal to. Range, the condition will be initial value and final value. So here you can write the for loop. Here you can write for. Here you can take where I is equal to 1. I less than or equal to 10. I plus plus. And here you declare one variable called sum. Where sum is equal to initially 0. Here I'll try to find the logic. Sum is equal to sum plus I. Come outside of the loop and print the statement. Document.write of print the sum. So how the for loop will execute? We already discussed initialization, condition, statements, and here increment or decrement. Initialization will done how many times? Only one time. Then condition. If the condition is true, then what to do? Execute the statements. And then increment or decrement. Okay, na? And again check the condition. If the condition is true, again execute the statement. This is the loop actually. Okay, na? So initial value is I initially, this is I less than or equal to 10, this is I plus plus. Always substitute the values. And this is sum I will take. Sum, and this is increment. So initial I is how much? 1. So 1 less than or equal to 10. Condition is true. So Sum is how much? 0 plus 1, 1. Increment I is 2. So here 2 less than equal to 10. True. Sum is how much? 1. 1 plus I is 2. 1 plus 2 is what? 3. Now increment I. I is how much? 3. Like that the loop will rotate. Finally you will get the output. Okay, now let us see here. Okay. So save the program. Here you can go to your F drive. Go to desktop. There you can go to desktop 2020. Here you can search HTML Satya. There I'll try to save the program. Was it clear? N.html. I'll try to save the program as N.html. Once check the output here. Go to my computer. There you can go to F drive. There you can see, sorry, go to desktop. Go to desktop 2020. There you can find HTML Satya. There you can find n.html. So I want to find the sum. So what is the sum? 55. Sum is 55. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 3, 6. 6 plus 4, 10. 10 plus 5, something like that. So this is the program to print the sum of natural numbers between 1 to 10. Okay. Confidently, you have to rotate the loop. Confidently, you have to rotate the loop. Any number divisible by 0, that is even. Any even number means number modulus 2. Any number divisible by 2, remainder is 0, that is even number. Otherwise, odd number. So if I give some numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I want to find the sum of even numbers and odd numbers between the 10 natural numbers. Means first I have to check whether 1 is even number or not, 2 is even number or not, 3 is even number or not. Like that, I need to check every number whether it is even or odd. So rotate the loop how many times? 10 times. Yes or no? And check whether each number is even number or odd number. So here first open HTML tag and here close your HTML tag. Okay, now here you can open head tag and here you can close the head tag. Within that you can open your script tag. Script type is equal to text slash JavaScript. Are following? Close the script tag. So I want to find the sum of even numbers and odd numbers between 1 to 10. So here first of all take one variable called even sum. How many outputs you will get? Two outputs, either even sum or and odd sum. So take two variables where odd sum is equal to initially 0. Now how many numbers you have to check? 10 numbers. So rotate the loop how many times? 10 times. Here you can write for where I is equal to 1, I less than or equal to 10, I plus plus. So rotate the loop 10 times. Okay, now check whether the first number. First number is 1. So check whether 1 is even number or not. After increment, I is 2, something like that. So here I will write, if I modulus 2 is equal to 0, then it is even number. Otherwise, it is odd number. Else here you can write odd number. So what to do? If the given number is even number, what to do? Add the I to even sum. So here you can write even sum is equal to even sum plus I. If it is odd number, add I to odd sum. So here you can write odd sum is equal to odd sum plus I. Something like this. This is even sum, that is what? Odd sum. Yes or no? Check whether given print the even sum and odd sum. Outside the loop, you can print. How to print? Document. Document.write. Document.write of. I want to print the even sum is. Even sum is plus even sum. And here I will try to print odd sum is plus odd sum. Odd sum is plus odd sum. Something like this. So save the program. Save the program as even.html. Okay, now go to your HTML Satya folder. And once you can open this HTML Satya, there you can see even.html. Check whether a given number is print the even sum and odd sum. So even sum is 30, odd sum is 25. After this, if you want to throw the cursor to the next line, you can throw. Here you can give BR. BR tag. Is it clear? Save it. Check, refresh your page, you can see the output. Even sum is 30, odd sum is 25. So what are the numbers I have taken here? Here I have taken the numbers as 10 numbers I have taken. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now let us check here. 2 is what? Even number. 4 is what? Even number. 6 is what? Even number. 8 is what? Even number. 10 is what? Even number. So add 2 plus 4, 6. 6 plus 6, 12. 12 plus 8, 20. 20 plus 10, 30. That is even sum. So odd sum. 1. 1 is odd number. 3. 1 plus 3, 4. 4 plus 3, 9. 9 plus 7, 16. 16 plus 9, 25. This is odd sum. So I am rotating the loop how many times? 10. Initial I is how much? 1. So condition is true. Come inside. 1 less than 1 modulus 2 is equal to 0. False. So odd sum. Initial odd sum is 0. 0 plus 1, 1. Next second number 2. 2 modulus 2 is equal to 0. True. Add the this number 2 to even sum and store in the same variable. Is it clear? If you practice loop, confidently write the loop, then think about what? Logic. So loop is a repetition process to perform a specific operation. If you want to perform any specific operation repeatedly, then you have to go for what? Loops. So here some students are asking, sir, how to print the numbers in reverse order? For example, I want to print like this, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. So in this scenario, initial I is how much? 10. Initial value is 10. I is equal to 10. Now number is incrementing or decrementing? If you observe clearly, number is decrementing. Number is decrementing. Means minus minus. If the number is decrementing, condition is what? Greater than or equal to. Number is incrementing, condition is less than or equal to. Decrementing, condition is greater than or equal to. Say I will try to write the code here. I'll write one for loop. For here I'll write where I is equal to 10. I greater than or equal to what? 1. I minus minus. Are following? So here bracket open, bracket close. So here what I will do? I will check. Now I will print the value I. So here document dot write of. I want to print I plus throw the cursor to the next line. Something like this. Okay, so initial I is how much? 10. 10 greater than equal to 1? True. Is it clear? Now come inside. Print I. What is I value? 10. Next I minus minus. I is how much? 9. 9 greater than equal to 1? True. Next 8. Like that the loop will rotate 10 times. It depends actually. L2.html. Just let us see here. I'll try to open my folder and check the output. Here you can see l2.html. It has to display all the values. Let us see here. I'll save the program. Save the program. I think we have not closed the script tag. Close the script tag, save, and once again you refresh. You'll get the output. All the values are displaying in order. Did you understand, everyone? If you want to print the values in ascending order, condition is what? Less than or equal to. If you want to print the values in descending order, greater than or equal to. Ascending order means increment operator. Descending order means decrement operator. You can print the values in any manner. Is it clear, everyone? So this is how you can work with the basic programs with loops in JavaScript. Is it clear? So as a developer, you must know how to work with these loops. And in the next video, we'll discuss about some other complicated programs like palindrome, Armstrong number, Fibonacci series. These three programs we'll discuss. Thank you. For more videos, try to subscribe to this channel.